What is up, everybody? It's Kamakazi here today, and today I wanted to show you guys 10 very epic maps that I think should come to Call of Duty Mobile in Season 11 or something like that. Hopefully, we'll get one or two. So let's get right into it, everybody. Now, before we start off this video, I'd just like to say these are not leaks or anything, you know. One or two of these maps may actually come to the game, and we'll talk about that when they come around. But these are not leaks or anything, guys. You know, I'm not trying to clickbait you. These are maps that I think should come into the game because I think they're really cool. Call of Duty Mobile has had a history of bringing in maps from other games, from their other, you know, Black Ops series and stuff like that, and bringing it into Call of Duty Mobile, basically for nostalgia, really. Almost every single one of our maps in-game are from an older version of Call of Duty that have just been remastered and added in. So that's why I kind of wanted to talk about some of these older maps from like Black Ops 2, stuff like that. And I tried to kind of find some diverse ones that would like, they all had very different styles. And so I wanted to show them all today because I feel like, you know, they would be a very great addition to Call of Duty Mobile. And I want to hear your guys' opinion, so make sure to tell me what you guys think. And also, if you could like and subscribe, of course, it helps me out so much. Sorry for the self-plug, but you know, you got to do it. So let's get right into it, everybody. At number 10, we have Turbine from Black Ops 2. Yeah, Black Ops 2 was definitely a very popular Call of Duty game. Quite possibly one of the most popular. You know, everyone loved it. And I must say, you know, Turbine was just a cool looking map overall. That's why I chose it for number 10. It's basically like this big turbine blade that had just fallen on the ground. And so it looked like kind of a just a cool map that I feel like, you know, various the center was kind of this turbine, and then you have like everyone else fighting. I just felt like it was a very cool scene to play in. That's something that we really haven't seen all too much in Call of Duty Mobile. You know, we've seen turbines in the Battle Royale, but never one that's like on the ground or like in multiplayer. I just feel like it's a cool scenery, kind of like a desert area, kind of like the scrapyard map, except non-airplane, like a turbine. I just feel like that was cool. At number 9, we have, I don't even know how to pronounce this, Aichen. It's two A's and a C-H-E-N. It's from World War II. You know, for any World War II fanatic, feel free to tell me what the heck, how to pronounce that. I don't know how you pronounce that. But basically, it's just like this apocalyptic like scene, you know, like evidently the city had been bombed or something. I don't know the exact history. I guess I'll have to, you know, add that in later when I edit this video. So basically, it's just this destroyed World War II like city from bombing or something. And it's just a cool looking map. You know, I like a lot of these kind of city maps. They're very like, you have the rows and everything. It provides a lot of opportunities for snipers, because as we all know, cities are usually like in rows, so you have like a clear line of sight for sniping, but you also have a lot of places to brawl. So there's a lot of cover here. It's not like, you know, crossfire was, in my opinion, some of the worst maps ever for Call of Duty Mobile. I wish it would go out of ranked because no one really likes it all that much. It's a place for campers, really. But in this map, there's a lot more cover. You have a lot more, like, bigger cars, I feel. So I feel like it'd be a lot harder to, you know, just sit there and camp the whole time. I feel like you can get a lot more kills just by actually playing. So I feel like this would be kind of like Crossfire 2.0, I feel. So, you know, maybe take Crossfire out of ranked and put in this map. Now, number 8 is based off of a kind of real-life location currently, Yemen, from Black Ops 2. Now, Yemen is a place that is currently in a lot of turmoil, a lot of civil war, a lot of bad things are going on in Yemen. So, I pray for anyone there, of course. You know, I hope you're doing okay. But this map is basically based on the city of Yemen. It's not like in the civil war that it is now. It's kind of like a city, like a little bit more of a an older city, I would say. So I really like this one, Yemen. It's from Black Ops 2. Very cool looking map, in my personal opinion. It's got a lot of places. Like, again, I like these city places because there's like this kind of like line. It's just the layout of the buildings work perfectly, and you have a perfect line of sight. But also a lot of places to brawl because you can hopefully put down cars to kind of block that site a little bit. So it was just very cool. I like kind of the slope of it as well. Being able to, you know, have different variations in like height and stuff provides for some different battle scenarios. You know, you don't want like, you know, just a completely flat map. You know, that's one of the reasons why I'm not a big fan of Nuketown. I know a lot of people like Nuketown, but I'm not a big fan. It's just too flat for me. Way too flat. So the next one is Carrier. Now, I know I'm such a hypocrite about talking about flat maps when literally Carrier is an extremely flat map. This is also from Black Ops 2. I tried to get in some diversity, but I'm just going to say it right now. A lot of these maps are from Black Ops 2 because Black Ops 2 is one of the best versions of Call of Duty, I would say, ever. So Carrier is just a cool location. You know, we've had a ship-like map before. It was like a big yacht kind of thing. However, we've never had like a carrier, like a military-style thing. It, you know, the other yacht was like hijacked. It was a cool-looking map, and I really like playing that. That was one of my favorite maps, really, when the game first came out. But I'd like another one kind of like that, and I think Carrier is the way to go. Carrier is just a cool-looking map. And it provides a lot of scenarios. You know, you'd think a carrier would be completely flat. However, this is kind of like it, they've added in a lot of different places to hide and a lot of different cover. So hopefully, you know, not too much camping going on. A lot of very good tactics and gameplay can be added into this to just make it a fun map. Now, at number 6, we have Riot. I'm going to try and go a little bit faster here. So, Riot is from Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Advanced Warfare was not too popular of a game, really, but I feel like this map in particular was really fun. It was an indoor map for the most part, and then you also have outdoor. It was kind of like Terminal, I would say, kind of like a Terminal type thing. And so, it was a medium-sized map. Terminal is very large. This one is kind of medium. I feel like it's a little bit less broken up than Terminal, so that might be an issue in terms of like camping. But I feel like overall, it's we'd be fine with that. Riot is just a cool, it's a cool map because it's basically a prison that's just like, you know, chopped up into. It's just been rioted. It's a very cool looking map. Now at number 5 we have Pipeline. Now Pipeline has actually been added in to COD previously. It's in the the BR of Call of Duty Mobile. And I don't play BR all that much. However, you know, a lot of people like to drop Pipeline because it's just a cool place. A lot of different areas to kind of fight, different buildings. So, you know, a building kind of focused map right there, which I know is a little bit unoriginal. However, I feel like Pipeline would just be overall a fun map to play on. You know, it's just a cool looking map, in my opinion. Now at number 4 we have Asylum, the second prison themed map in this in this video. Now Asylum is from World at War. Yes, World at War. I don't think World at War was actually all that popular either, but this was a cool map in my opinion, and it was just very cool looking, kind of like, I don't know, like almost like a torture chamber, not even like a like an asylum anymore. It was crazy. It just looks cool. I'll show you guys the picture of kind of what it looked like from a top view. So I feel like, you know, looking at this map and of course the gameplay, I feel like it just was a cool looking map that had a lot of different gameplay to it, you know, a lot of different situations, and allowed for snipers as well as shotgun, you know, whatever, whoever, SMG, LMG, whatever you play with. I feel like this was a good map all around to play on. So that was a cool one. Now True Shipment, guys. Okay, this is an interesting one because I feel like, you know, Shipment 1944 was epic and insane, and this is purely visual, guys. However, that was from World War II. The most famous version of Shipment was the original one, which was the real Shipment, like the current day Shipment. You have all the cargo crates and everything, and I felt like that one was just a cool, it just looked cooler, in my opinion, than World War II, than the World War II version. You know, I do agree with COD's decision to, you know, bring in something of World War II type, because we haven't had any maps similar to that. However, I feel like Shipment, you know, just the look of Shipment was always very cool, so I'd like that one. Now, at number 2, Combine. Combine is actually one of the smallest maps that I know of in COD, like, anywhere. It's a very small map, very brawly. It centers around, like, I don't know, what you'd call it, like, this big mansion looking thing. I don't know what you'd even call it, but it's just, you just fight in it, and it's actually a very small map. I know I just said big, but it's a very small map. It's smaller than Shipment, I'd say. It's an extremely small map, so definitely I would like this to come into the game, because everyone likes brawly maps, not even for the look of it, just the idea of a brawly map, you know. That's why people like Nuketown. I'm not a big fan of Nuketown. I don't know, it's just not my favorite, but that's the reason why people like Shipment as well. Very brawly, very intense, very hectic. You know, you gotta watch out to be not too aggressive, because you can jump on a bunch of people and just instantly die. So yes, that's Combine for you guys. Now at number 1, we have one that could actually be coming into the game, and that is Dome. Now there was a vote a while back to see who won, you know, what map should come into the game, and this is one of the maps that won. It's a very popular game. It's a very popular map. One of, I would say, you know, the most played, evidently. And overall, it looks very cool. I don't know the, you know, background behind it. I'll have to put it in the, edit it in. But all I know is it's this huge dome and you just fight around it. It's a very, very large dome. I don't know what it's for, but just, it's a cool looking map. It's like post-apocalyptic. I don't even know how to explain it. And I would really like for this one to come into the game. Hopefully it does in Season 11. You know, this is one of those ones that I think actually could. Now, I have two bonuses for you guys here because, you know, I wanted to give you guys a little more than just 10. So one of the bonuses is Hard Hat from Modern Warfare 3. So, you know, I like the Modern Warfare series a lot, and Hard Hat was just kind of like a, I would say, small and medium map, and it's this construction site. We haven't really gotten any construction-themed maps or city-themed maps, I'd say, other than High Rise. High Rise was definitely a city-themed map, but this construction theme, I just felt like it was very different, and it looks like a cool map. You know, when you have something that's being constructed or something, or like something that's been destroyed, or it gives you a lot of advantages in terms of making the map, because you can put down rubble and everything and like construction materials as cover. So this is a very high cover map. You're never going to be caught getting just camp, you know, someone camping there and sniping at you, because that just ruins the game sometimes. It annoys me a lot. Now, from the bonus, we have Scorch. Yes, this is the last one, guys. So I hope you guys like this one. Now, Scorch is actually an interesting one. It's from Infinite Warfare. Now, for those of you guys that don't know, Infinite Warfare was in like 2017, 2016. It was a pretty big failure, according to COD and everything. It wasn't as popular as people expected. It looked like a very cool game. I don't know, you know, maybe it was just a little bit too out there in terms of where COD went with it. Very futuristic. So Scorch is like this mining, it's like this mining drill thing with lots of lava and everything, and it's on this moon or something, but they're mining, and there's tons of lava, and it's just dangerous. It's a cool-looking map. I love the cool-looking maps, you know. For those of you guys that don't know, that's what I'm kind of obsessed with. I love the, you know, just the cool-looking maps. And lava? Who doesn't like lava? Lava looks cool. So it's a very orangey kind of looking map, and I feel like it would make a cool addition to Call of Duty Mobile. So those are my 12, actually, that I think should come into Call of Duty Mobile. If you guys, you know, like this video or anything, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, because it helps me out so much, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Give me your list down below, because I'd like to hear what you guys want into this game. You know, I'd love to hear your opinions, and I will respond back. And definitely just me trying to get comments and stuff. I know I'm going to be upfront with you guys, but I do like to hear some of your guys' opinions, to be honest with you. So thank you guys for watching. I will see you next time. This is Kamakazi, signing out. I love y'all. Bye.